After years of progress, the newly homeless population in New Orleans is on the rise. Intense gentrification following the devastation of Hurricane Katrina has caused rent and housing to skyrocket in many neighborhoods. More people are seeking shelter, sleeping in cars, or abandoned houses.
The marketing now here is $800 to $900 to $1,000 for a one-bedroom house or a two-bedroom house. But some unfortunate single parents can't afford $800.
Despite working two jobs, Royon Burbank still doesn't make enough to afford housing for herself and toddler.
I called Child Protection Services on myself because I didn't want myself to get in trouble or even lose my kid. So I had to call them, tell them, well, hey, you know, I have a situation, I'm in an abandoned house.
I called and I took my chances to get myself on my feet because I have a beautiful son. I can't let him down.
According to Housing NOLA, the agency that tracks New Orleans housing trends, rent prices have gone up by 102% and housing values by 109% between the year 2000 and 2013, while the city's annual median income has remained the same at about $37,000.
We're used to making progress, so it's very distressing to us to see the tide turning in the wrong direction. We're seeing, you know, families sleeping in their cars. We're seeing families sleeping outside in parks.
The lack of affordable housing taking a toll on the city's most vulnerable, the disabled, elderly, and low-income wage earners, affecting many children.
I'm sorry.
This father and son have been living on the street and in a friend's storage room about the size of a large closet. They became homeless after Norman Carter was unable to work following a bicycle accident last summer.
Past 7 months without housing, it's unbelievable. I mean, to walk and ask people for money so that you can eat, or to buy medicine for your kid. Pampers.
Advocates say more funds are needed to offset the high rent and home prices. The majority of Unity's funding comes from the federal government. For now, Burbank's son is staying with his grandfather while Unity works to get him and his mom a place she can afford. And the agency is helping Carter get his disability claim in order and get Elijah in a Head Start program.
It's going to get better. We've come a long way. It's going to get better.
Carter trying to stay optimistic while waiting for a place to call home. Stacy Plaisance, The Associated Press, New Orleans.